Good morning, everyone. I am Doc Stout, and if you've been following my streams, I'm going to be trying something just a little different from what I've been doing lately. Instead of launching another series, I'm going to give a little bit of credit to all those independent developers out there who make these small roguelike games, or roguelite games. I'm going to be starting with Risk of Rain. What characterizes a roguelike or a roguelite for me is some sort of procedural or random generation, permanent death, and may or may not include the ability to increase your character across multiple playthroughs, or in some way unlock some sort of progress. Risk of Rain, which was available in the recent Humble Bundle, is a platform shooter where the longer you play, the harder it gets. Let's just jump in game and see. I've gotten a couple of unlocks, including one of the other creatures, the Enforcer. We're going to start with the basic guy, the Commando, mainly because I'm pretty terrible with the Enforcer. So we start here in the Desolate Forest. I'm going to very quickly open these containers, and as fast as I can, I need to find the teleporter. Because these enemies start out pretty easy. But the longer I play, the harder they get. I'll take a little falling damage for no reason there. Oh! This is a little bit more twitch reflex intensive than the typical games I play. If you've been watching the stream, I've been doing card games and RPGs and strategy games. So, an action game is a little bit outside my wheelhouse. Oh, boy. Alright. Got a couple of special abilities I can use here. There's the basic double tap shot, which is what I'm using here. Then there's that automatic shot. There's also a bigger shot, which knocks people back. And I think the automatic shot is the one that stuns. And I've also got a dive out of the way of trouble. Alright, our timer is up in the upper right-hand corner. We're currently still at very easy at 1 minute and 21 seconds. We've cleared the left side of the screen, which means that the teleporter's somewhere over here. I wonder if I can... Nope. Actually, I have to fight this guy legit. There are some enemies that may stand in places where you can shoot them, but they can't really effectively attack you. As you can see, I'm leveling up as I'm killing things. I've also got money in the upper left-hand corner. This is a Beat the Average game available now on the current Humble Indie Bundle. I have enough to both get one of those items. I think I'm going to unlock the question mark. That is Head Stompers. Hurt enemies by falling. Okay, that was not a new item for me. So I hope there's something cool in this. Oh, that's new. Rapid Mitosis. Not so good right now. Alright, still got $22 to spend on upgrades. We've not found anything remotely good. I could use the shrine, but historically, as I've played this game, I have not been so great at succeeding in the challenge shrines. Take a little bit more unnecessary falling damage. Looks like the teleporter's probably going to be over here, unless it's way up to the left there. Okay, here we go. And we have a convenient chest as well. Got an elite little lizard man guy there. Clear these guys out. Gain gold over time. This guy hits pretty hard. Alright, no time like the present to trigger the boss. Hopefully I can get that item real quickly. Wandering Vagrant. He's going to be a large version of the little mobs we've got flying around, that jellyfish thing. And for 90 seconds, there's going to be a constant spawn of new enemies. So for that 90 seconds, I'm going to attempt to be elsewhere. You can see the boss telegraphs where he's going to shoot his little, I don't know, bouncy ball things. So long as I keep moving and I'm not there, he doesn't actually do that much damage to me. It helps if I use my special abilities while pointed at the boss. Alright, gotta keep moving. Alright, this area is getting a little clogged. Ow. Use the mines. That took a big chunk off the boss. Get moving again. Mitosis might actually give me my mines back in a time where I could actually use them. Ow. Took a lot of damage there. Alright, so I've beaten the timer. Oh boy. However, I've taken a lot of damage. Drop those mines. That'd give me a nice little level up. Did I get the boss with that at all? I don't think I did. Oh, come on! I get a cool item if I kill this guy. Got it. I gotta survive long enough to get the item, but... Fire shield. Retaliate on taking heavy damage. Okay, that took the boss out. Mines are new to me. I don't think I've ever had this item before. Alright, so now in order to teleport out of the level, I gotta kill the 21 enemies that have already spawned. Heavy action games like this are probably going to be the sort of thing where I'm not going to be able to participate in the Twitch chat if you are watching on Twitch. My apologies. Okay, I got 17 of these guys left. Now 16. Double tap that guy to death. Dodge. 15 left. Alright. 14. I think most of them are in a cluster up here. Be nice to use this 254 to get some stuff. My difficulty has gone up to easy from very easy. Jump here and not take any chances. Some of my attacks are not very effective while jumping. Only got 8 guys left to kill. Oh yeah, that's right. I left a bunch of guys over here. Ow. Alright, let's take a slightly safer route. Oh, there's a chest there I can buy too. So 6 guys left. Buy the chest, which gives me a monster tooth. I heal every time I kill something. Seems pretty useful. I think I wasted my dodge there. Alright, I have 2 more enemies left. Difficulty still easy, but I think the next stage is going to be very much tougher for me. Oh, that's right. I had the head stomper. So I only have 1 enemy left. All right. Let's get out of here. I think I'm going to have to get pretty lucky because I'm about to cross out of easy at the 8-minute mark. So teleport out, and all my money turns into extra XP. I'm level 8 going into the damp caverns. I kind of like my item loadout. Those, of course, are going to be random every playthrough. Life savings is ticking up for me already. I just got to find the teleporter pretty much immediately. Oh, that's awkward. I can't really kill that guy. Oops. That was the wrong button. Just leave some mines there for the next guy. So, items are 94 now. Chests are 147. Scaling with my ability to get money. Got some mushroom dudes showing up, and we find the teleporter, which I think I'm just going to pop immediately before this gets any harder than medium. Okay, there's the boss, the Ancient Wisp, which is in a very inconvenient position for me. I don't know that I like where these mushroom guys are, so I'll clear one out if I can. Yeah, this is gonna get ugly real fast. I could have bought those items. Gotta survive the 90 seconds while guys are still summoning. I'm not sure what banished and chained means. I don't think I've ever actually beaten the Ancient Wisp. Okay, I got some of my mines back. That should help. Might be able to go to a slightly more dangerous area like that. Do something like that. Get the healing. Infusion. Killing an enemy permanently increases my health. 77, 78. I don't think I can afford to keep taking damage like that. Okay, I got 41 enemies, and I have to survive. I mostly just have to survive until my mines come off cooldown and then deal with the Ancient Wisp. I'm not quite sure how to do that. And I'm not sure I've actually ever successfully beaten the second stage. In fact, I'm pretty sure I have not. So this is a new boss for me, as well as a possibility of a first kill. Oh, that's ugly. Can I get to a safe spot? No, it's not really safe. There's that one guy who can shoot at me from here. It's safer than walking over there, though. Okay, the automatic weapon doesn't seem to work very well here. That works very well, though. As soon as he dies, I won't really have anything to worry about. I can just bounce over here. Okay. That'll take care of those guys. Oh, mistimed the jump. And every time I kill, I get a little bit more health. Both on the max and on the healing. Alright. Couple of nasty guys right up there. I think my best strategy here is just to drop mines and get out. Oh, that hardly did anything to them, though. Alright, how am I doing on health? 300. I just got a blast. Alright, now I can pretty safely kill these guys. The boss is still going to be a problem, though. I should be watching my cooldowns instead of just, like, randomly hitting the buttons, hoping they're up. Alright, 16 enemies. I think I want the chains. The barbed wire hurts nearby enemies. That seems really good in this situation. I don't know how hurtful that thing is. That poison cloud. I think I just want to stay out of it, though. Alright, this seems like a good place for mines. Yeah, they're gonna attack me. It's gonna hurt. Man, 22 seconds left on my mines. Ugh. Doesn't seem like something. Alright, I think I just gotta be careful here. Can I actually damage these guys with my barbed wire? No, they're just gonna freak out. Let's see if I can't get them to walk over here and drop the mines. Alright. Hit as hard as I can. Oh, I do not want to die. Well, I've just got one guy to kill. Okay. I think I gotta heal up and take on the boss, who's at full. I've never beaten this boss, but he's the only enemy left. He's also in a very inconvenient spot for me. Alright, wander over the mines. Well, that's really nice. He hit me for a lot of my health, though. I hate to cheese it like this, but... oof. Oh, he also makes dudes. Well, that kind of sucks. I am not healing very fast. Bail. Alright, I got him at about half. Okay, maybe it'll actually be better for me to fight him down here. I'm not sure. So I can get a little bit of distance on him. Not have to worry about him constantly blasting me with his attacks. I think I got this. I'm probably gonna get aced the instant I go to the next. Oh my goodness. This isn't remotely fair. Oh boy. Alright, let's just get out of here. Alright, I am not gonna lose it here. At least that's what I keep telling myself. This is the first time I ever beat that boss. Alright, just leveled up. Nice. First time I made it to level 3. Now I have these cool frost things around me. Alright, let's see how horrendous level 3 is. I've got quite a loadout right now. The Sunken Tombs. Difficulty, very hard. I can't say that I've ever seen this game to be particularly easy. Wow. I hit those guys with all of my specials. Seems to have done exactly nothing. Oh, that's cool. I do like that. Well, this is a ninja guy? He's now a dead ninja guy. This is going to be the first time I'm seeing a lot of the enemies on this stage. Uh-oh. Oh, that's weird. Okay, I teleported over here. Oh, boy. Very quickly must get away. Dodge 7 lethal attacks. With Commander. Commando, that is something new. All these ninjas flying about. Oh. Uh-oh. I thought I had my, Oh, that's gonna do it for me at 19 minutes and 42 seconds. I was crushed, but I broke all of my records on this. Level 11, 1939, two bosses, 11 items, and I unlocked something cool. This item will now drop. Well, I'd like to thank you for watching me play Risk of Rain. Definitely something a little different from my typical streams. I honestly acquitted myself a little bit better than I thought I would. I will be back tomorrow with probably a different roguelike. I think I want to try this just a little bit before I go back to strategy games, RPGs, that sort of thing. A little bit slower pace. I'll continue to try something a little more action-y. And a little bit more bite-sized pieces instead of these long series that I've been doing on YouTube lately. Thanks for watching. This has been Doc Stout playing Risk of Rain. And until next time, I am signing out.